So when I was given the chance to run for a seat in Congress, I looked at it through several lenses, and the one that spoke most profoundly to me was the energy lens. And probably like yourself, I hope to move through my career. Every chapter that I made along the list was, where can I do more good? And I thought doing a whole lot of good for this country was coming to Washington and establishing a comprehensive energy plan. No sophisticated nation like ours, no world-leading economy like ours, can continue without a progressive better policy that envelops into a comprehensive energy plan that is routinely updated and always implemented. And so that was my goal. And you are part and parcel of the elements of that wonderful comprehensive plan strategy. To be able to insert a great diversity in our mix, to wean us off of this gluttonous dependency on fossil-based fuels, oftentimes finding us sending hundreds of billions of dollars a year to foreign governments that are then fighting us on battlefields. We're paying for both ends of a war. So this whole effort here speaks to sound foreign policy. It speaks to sound fiscal policy. Because what we do when we encourage this sort of mix in our energy outcomes is grow jobs, American jobs, that allow us to embrace the intellectual capacity of this nation and put new products on the shelf that will enable us to be more efficient in how we use our energy supplies, or enable us to do renewable outputs that utilize the forces of Mother Nature in a very benign fashion, utilizing the wind, the sun, the water, the soil to make a difference. It's a no-brainer in my book. And finally, you know, when we look at the fiscal policy sense that all of this meant, as we continue to willingly set the energy consumer and American energy consumer dollars into these foreign budgets, we're just growing our debt with these nations. And our whole attachment over this dependency on oil is leveraging that pulls us into these conflicts that find us fighting over a commodity called oil. So you're doing great work here in terms of stewardship of sound energy policy, fiscal policy, foreign policy. The final element would be that of environmental policy. I'm a firm believer that we have to pay attention to climate change and global warming. We see it happening around us. The extremes are undeniable, and that's worldwide. Look at the flooding, record flooding in Europe as we speak. So the world has been gripped by this phenomenon. We need to be better stewards of the environment. And how better to do that than remove these elements that find 19 pounds of carbon pollution per gallon for every bit of oil we're using to transport us or freight around this country. We need to make certain we're doing far better than the $7.2 billion of carbon emission a year. And you do that by using the green opportunities called renewable energies. And whatever our mix, and hopefully it grows more and more strong and grows more and more domestically produced, however that mix is achieved, it needs to be done with the utmost of efficiency. Energy efficiency should be seen as our fuel of choice. That should be our number one priority. And then we go to concepts that have us thinking outside of the barrel, bringing us into renewables. I'm so thrilled about this. When I came here in my first month in office in January of 2009, was able to sit down with a number of my colleagues who formed the SEEC, the Sustainable Energy and Environmental Coalition. Today, we have grown that to over 50 plus members, second largest caucus now for us as Dems. Kara Allen here is our executive director. SEEC is trying to green up the thinking of all of us in the House. And we use our personal experience, our professional experience, to share the anecdotal evidence that it's doable, it's not a political killer. It's actually an enhancer. And the second order that I want to mention to you was, when I first came to town, I asked to be assigned to energy and commerce. I'm an engineer by background, developed energy policy for 15 years in the state of Assembly, implemented it through my assignment and my serve. I thought that was credible enough to try and break the rules. They wouldn't let me. You have to put in some time. So I spent time on the Science Based Consent Committee, where Jean was one of the super staff members of that committee. Kate Crucci now is our legislative director. So we're surrounded by people who truly believe in the green agenda. And eventually, in my third term, just before the end of my second term, I was named to energy and commerce, and now I'm the ranker on environment and the economy. So I mention this because I'm here, a very willing partner. Use us. We want to be your strongest voice, your fullest voice, your partner to make this agenda happen. This is American jobs, it's America's wisdom and intellect put into a construct that allows us to hope, where we are better stewards of the environment. And I told a group of youth leaders the other day, hundreds of state leaders, people who are in youth leadership, do not let us do damage to your political generation by ignoring the facts out there. The current damage going on, the sequestration, and the lack of vision, and the lack of proximity, is going to get us in deep stead into a deep bit of trouble. As far as I see it, this agenda for energy transformation, energy efficiency, renewables, is a nonpartisan agenda. Republicans and Democrats alike benefit. Republicans and Democrats alike have cleaner air. Republicans and Democrats alike have less dependency on foreign produced oil that will then keep us out of some of these conflicts. So we all stand to gain. It's great to have you here in town. Great to have your attention. Please call upon us. Call Tonko, New York 20, Capital Region of New York. We're here ready to go with this agenda with lightning speed. Thank you so much.